إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أيها المسلمون It has been collected by our Imam Muslim رحمه الله تعالى from the hadith of Abu Hurairah رضي الله عنه that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam he said من سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما سهل الله له به طريقا إلى الجنة that whoever sets out on a path seeking knowledge therein then Allah عز وجل He will make easy for him. He will facilitate for him a path to paradise. The Jannah, it has a path. It has one path that leads there. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has sent His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam clarifying that way. Clarifying in details the way that leads to paradise in the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And likewise clarifying in details the ways of corruption, and the ways of evil and disobedience, and the ways that lead to the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah, He mentioned in His book, هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا. That verily it is He, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has sent His Messenger. He has sent His Messenger بالهدى ودين الحق. He has sent Him with guidance and the religion of truth, so that it may be victorious and apparent over all other religions. And sufficient is Allah as a witness over this. وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was sent with huda. He was sent with huda, guidance. The reality of this guidance is that it is al-ilm al-nafi', that it is beneficial knowledge. Knowledge of the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Knowledge of the halal and the haram and that which is permissible and impermissible. Knowledge of the paths that lead to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And likewise knowledge of those corrupt ways of disobedience and evil. And the application of that knowledge. Likewise, he was sent with that sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa deen al-haq. And this is the religion of truth. Al-ilmu. Al-nafi'u wal-amalu salih. The righteous and upright good knowledge. And the righteous and upright noble actions. The beneficial knowledge and the righteous actions. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with. And in order to enter paradise, one has to learn that way. He has to learn that knowledge. He has to obtain that knowledge. And that knowledge does not come free. It is a provision from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But He, tabaraka wa ta'ala, He has made means to obtain it. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned, إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ بِالْتَعَلُّمُ That the knowledge will be obtained only by way of learning. That the knowledge will be obtained only by way of learning. The way to paradise is clarified in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The ways of evil and wickedness, they're clarified in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The good of this life has been clarified in detail by the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and likewise in the hereafter.
من سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما. Whoever sets out on a path to seek knowledge, knowledge of the Quran, a knowledge of the Sunnah of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what his companions were upon, from the beneficial knowledge and righteous actions, سهل الله له به طريقا إلى الجنة. Allah will make easy for him by way of that knowledge a path to paradise, a path to paradise. But the issue must be known that there is a paradise in this life, even before the hereafter. And likewise, this is with regards to knowledge, and with regards to understanding and knowing what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam he was sent with, and learning the revelation and learning the book and pondering over the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and understanding his tawheed, and having sincere faith in Iman, based upon principles and foundations and qawaid and usul. A believer, he will find the paradise in his heart, and he will have jannah and satisfaction in this life before the hereafter. He will have a paradise in his heart in this life before the hereafter. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned, إِنَّ فِي الدُّنْيَا جَنَّةٌ مَنْ لَمْ يَدْخُلْهَا لَا يَدْخُلْ جَنَّةَ الْآخِرَةِ. That verily there is a paradise in this life. Whoever does not enter that paradise, he will not enter the paradise in the hereafter. Before one can find the paradise of the hereafter, he must find the joy and the delight of knowing the tawfiq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowing the truthfulness of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with certainty and being pleased with al-Islam as a way of life and a deen and a way to act and to live and to abide by. At this time he will have a great blessing from Ash-Shakur, the one who accepts the deen subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will grant him contentment and satisfaction in his heart. And he will find peace, and he will have a joy that cannot be bought and it cannot be purchased. The joy of the paradise in his life, the knowing of the servant, his Lord. The fact that the servant, he knows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It has been narrated by Anas radiallahu anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned to his companions radiallahu anhum, إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ فَارْتَعُوا. If you go past the gardens of paradise, partake therein and benefit. Enjoy yourself. If you go past the gardens of paradise, enjoy yourself and benefit therein. فَارْتَعُوا. They said to him, رضي الله عنهم وصلى الله عليه وسلم وما رياض الجنة. And what are the gardens of paradise, O Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم? The Messenger, he mentioned, حلق الذكر. They are the circles of knowledge and the circles of remembrance. Sitting in the gatherings of the people of knowledge and the students of knowledge, and learning the correct aqidah and the correct deen, learning the correct tawheed and the iman, learning about the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His greatness and His glory and His majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala, learning in details the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and seeing the proofs and evidences clearly that he is the Messenger of Allah. This is a jannah and a paradise that cannot be purchased and it cannot be bought. And once one obtains it, no one can steal it from him. It is his blessing and a favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in this manner, and like this, clarifying this meaning, many of the people of knowledge throughout history, they have given their books and their works and hadith and clarification of the deen, names that carry this meaning. For example, we have the book Riyab al-Uqala by Ibn Hibban, rahimahullah ta'ala, Gardens of the Intelligence. And likewise, the famous book by An-Nawawi, Riyab al-Saliheen, Gardens of the Righteous, clarifying the narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his sunnah. These narrations and the knowledge that they contain therein, they're gardens for the righteous. The righteous, they will be in gardens of bliss and happiness and joy, reading in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions. And like this, likewise, in Nuqayyim, after them, he has a book, Rawdatul Muhibbin, those people who truly love Allah, there's a garden for them. Likewise, he mentioned them in his book. And it is known, likewise, even after them in the later generations, the people of knowledge that continue to understand this meaning, the garden of and the delight of joy that is found in knowledge and seeking knowledge and learning the deen, Ar-Rawdul Murbi' by Buhuti, rahimahullah ta'ala. These are books about knowledge and about the sunnah and about the halal and the haram and about the proper creed and the proper belief, about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His attributes. And they are gardens for the righteous. And they are gardens for the upright. And they are means of happiness and joy and pleasure in this life. There are means of happiness and joy and pleasure in this life. It has been narrated by Ibrahim ibn Adham, rahimahullah ta'ala, that he mentioned that they're in a paradise, that verily they have a delight that no one can find and no one can purchase. And if the people of the dunya, they knew about this delight, they would try to fight them and take it from them with swords. They would try to fight them and take it from them with swords. It's the delight and the joy of knowledge. the delight and the joy of a believer, have the certainty and the meaning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and knowing His deen, and knowing the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and knowing His way, and knowing His sunnah. Being upon that way, a believer, he will find delight in this life before the hereafter. He will find delight in this life before the hereafter. أقول ما تسمعون أستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد. With regards to the knowledge, it must be obtained. It's an obligation. As mentioned by Anas radiallahu anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned that famous narration, طَالَبُ الْعِلْمِ فَرِيضَةٌ عَلَى كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ, that seeking knowledge is an obligation upon every Muslim. But the knowledge, it must be sought in the proper manner. And it must be sought from the proper sources. From the greatest calamity that we find in the ummah. And from the means of misguidance and destruction. And for the deterioration of the ummah. Is the fact that the people, they saw knowledge from the wrong sources. And the people, they learned the deen. And they learned the tafsir of the Qur'an and the understanding of the hadith and the ahkam al-shar'iyya and the creed and the aqidah from the wrong sources. And in this manner, it has been mentioned by Muhammad ibn Sirin, rahimahullah ta'ala, the famous statement. He said, إِنَّ هَذَا الْعِلْمَ دِينٌ فَانْضُوا عَمَّنْ تَأْخُذُونَ دِينَكُمْ. That verily this knowledge, it is your religion. So look to where you take your knowledge from. And look to where you learn your deen from. Because this knowledge, the actions are based upon it. And if the knowledge is correct and upright, then likewise the actions will be correct and upright. But if the knowledge is corrupt, or if the knowledge has deficiency, then based upon that deficiency will be a deficiency in the actions. And on the Day of Judgment, the actions will be weighed. Not everybody who speaks with knowledge or mentions the narrations, and not everybody who claims to have a degree or have some recommendation from the people of knowledge, not everybody is upright. Rather, that which will clarify that is his actions and his deeds and his biography and his way that he lives upon and his community and what he's known by. The people of uprightness and the people of the sunnah, they have the sunnah apparent on them. And the people of piety and righteousness, that is seen in their speech and action, and that is seen in their deeds. These are the people who we learn from, and these are the scholars that we take knowledge from. The people who are known for the proper creed and the proper belief and the proper methodology, and are also known for the proper behavior and conduct. And are known for the proper upright behavior, conduct, and manners. These are the people of knowledge, and they are saved and preserved at every time. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "La tazalu ta'ifatun min ummati zahirina 'ala al-haq," that there will always remain a group from my ummah who was victorious upon the truth. These are the people of knowledge. And Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, "Illam yakun ahl al-hadith fala adri man hum," that if they are not the people of hadith, the people of knowledge, then I do not know who they are. So they are apparent, they are victorious, and their way is known. And their evidence is clear, and their conduct and their actions and their speech. These are the people that the ummah, they hold fast to. As for the people who claim knowledge and their actions are contrary, then it's clear that they are misguided. They're misguided either by desires and whims, or they're misguided by shubuhat and misconceptions in the deen. It's very important for a believer to be concerned where he learns from, and to be concerned where the knowledge he obtains comes from, and to the people who he benefits from. And this is the way of a believer in this life. And the one who finds a good teacher, a good scholar, to benefit from, let him hold fast. Let him hold fast and benefit, and follow the light. And follow the light that he's been given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma allimna ma yinfa'una, wa anfa'na bima alamtana, wa zidna ilma, wa la tukilna ila fusina tarfada'ayn. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana, wa fil akhirati hasana, wa qina adab an-nar. Allahumma aslih lana dinana, alladhi huwa ismatu amrina. وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي فيها معادنا وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا وجعل حياة زيادة لنا في كل خير والموت راحة لنا من كل شر. أقول ما تسمعون أستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.